안녕하세요. 제 이름은 나미입니다. Hi, it's Nami, and today I wanted to talk to you and show you this really cute pink bag. And it is, in fact, the bag that I came to Canada with as a refugee. I just did my what's in my bag video, so this is gonna kind of be like what's in my bag video 18 years ago. It was actually Michael's idea, and I think that it's really smart, and it's really interesting, and it would be definitely fun to see what is, in fact, inside this bag full of... So I first came to Canada in 2000 and... No, year 2000, and that was, like, 17 and a half years ago. My mom, she only brought one suitcase with her, and... I had this one bag and the clothes on my back, and my mom also the clothes on her back, and she brought $100 in cash, and that's all we came to Canada with. And now we are so blessed with you know, all of the blessings that God has provided us. Thinking about where we came from and how we came here is definitely humbling, and also a good reminder that we really don't own anything, and you know, we don't come with much, and we leave with nothing as well. In terms of, you know, leaving the world, we leave with nothing that we can tangibly hold here. But I feel like this video, I don't want to be too heavy-hearted. I would like for it to be a fun, cute video as well. So we'll look at the things in this little... I thought this was Miffy my whole life. I don't think this is Miffy. I think this is like a knockoff Miffy. I don't think it's really Miffy. But I think we'll find lots of cute things in here. So let's take a look. Here at the front it says, yes, I like to eat apples. Apples, yum, 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 yum. And then the tag here says, young art. So if you were wondering where this bag is from, they're probably out of business. Or I'd be surprised if they're still making bags. Oh, I didn't know there was a zipper here. There's a little zipper here at the back, which has access to the contents of the bag. The front has a little buckle closure with a drawstring. And the first item we see here, I haven't looked at this bag, the contents of this bag, in like forever. This is like my first impression. We've got my shoes that I wore when I was 4 years old. The shoes that I wore when I came. I'm smiling right now because this color is so me. Oh my gosh, look how beat up I wore these shoes until we literally had like no money. These are so cute. This is actually, though, this is my favorite color. I think when I was younger, I used to really like girly things, and I used to like the color pink, and I really liked girly things. But especially in the environment that I was being babysat in, I was told that I was a girly girl, and there's a term in Korean called 공주병, and I was accused of being 공주병, having a sickness that makes you believe that you're a princess. It's kind of like you have a mental illness that makes you like, it's kind of like, what would be the English equivalent? Like a superiority complex or something like that? Like you just feel like a princess all the time, and you act like spoiled like a princess. Though I don't think, like when I asked my mom about that recently, she said that I wasn't that much of like a spoiled brat. I wasn't a spoiled brat, but I just really liked girly things. Yeah, I really did like girly things. And I think when I heard that, I was shocked. I was like, oh my gosh, as a four-year-old, this is like four-year-old brain. If I am being accused of having 공주병, or like believing that I'm a princess, or acting like a princess because I like pink and frilly things, I'm gonna be hated. Like, people won't like that. And so I totally just denied all pink, any pink in my life. I denied everything. I denied all girly things, and I became a tomboy all the way until I was in grade 8. And then I started to like a little bit of pink again, but all the way from basically before I started elementary school all the way until grade 8 school, my whole childhood was just tomboy life. And when I look at these shoes, this is so me. This is like, I feel like only now I'm starting to be able to be more of who I am without worrying about what other people would think of me or if I would be hated or disliked, because I had a lot of that issue growing up. Like, I was always scared of not being accepted, especially because I had a lot of rejection and abandonment issues. But anyways, yes, these shoes are so cute. They're so me. Color is on point. Matches my couch almost. Matches my purse, actually, that was in my what's in my bag video. And then the next thing I pull out, oh, it's the dress. It's the dress I wore. Oh my gosh, it's so cute. The smell reminds me of like when you fold away washed blankets and then you put it away in like a closet, but you don't, like, the smell of the detergent goes away, but it just smells like stored fabric. Do you know what I mean? It doesn't smell dirty, but it just smells like stored away fabric. But yeah, this is a dress from Aesop Kid. Oh my gosh, it's 100 centimeters. I was that short? No, my mom probably dressed me in this from when I was... No, oh my gosh. Because Galahad right now, he wears clothes meant for 100 centimeters tall. But he's 110 centimeters tall. Galahad was taller than I was when I came to Canada. By the way, for newer viewers, Galahad is my first son. And he just turned 4. But he's really tall. He's in the 90th percentile height for children his age. Oh my gosh, that's crazy. When I first came to Canada, I was shorter than my son is right now. I was the same age as him when I came. Oh, I was so little. Anyway, this is a cute dress. There's a zipper at the back. And we came in March, year 2000. So it was kind of chilly. It might have been snowy, I don't know. The last thing in this bag. Is it the last thing? Oh my gosh. It literally is the last thing in this bag. Is my fur coat. My Dalmatian's fur coat. Oh, it's so cute. If Galahad was a girl, I'd totally dress him in this. I could literally dress him in this and he'd be like so fashionable. I don't think it would be weird for a young boy to wear a Dalmatian fur coat. Right? Pretty cute. Oh my gosh, it has my hair on it. What? It has my 4-year-old hair on it. Can you see that? It has my 4-year-old hair on it. It's like brown and permed. Because when I was 4, I had permed hair. Because my mom's a hairstylist. She always did my hair. There's so much hair on here. I already see like 5 strands of hair. This hair is 18 years old. 18-year-old hair. There's little pockets. I was expecting something to be in there, but that one's empty. This one's empty too. Oh, but this is so cute. It's such a cute jacket. Yeah, but everything I had was like frilly and, oh, it's so small. And like pink and like cute and pretty because I liked those things. I'll insert some pictures of some childhood photos that I find, if I find any. They're probably at my mom's house, but I can go over and take a look. And I'll pull some pictures of like when we first came to Canada. This is literally just everything that was on my back, excluding my underwear. So that's it. That was what was in my 4-year-old backpack and my 4-year-old outfit coming to Canada, escaping from... my crazy violent home in Korea. If you haven't heard of that story, I'll link it right here. I don't know. I hope this video was fun or interesting. Do you have any interesting memories from when you were 4 years old? It's crazy to think that when I first came to Canada, I was the same age as Galahad is now. Like, Galahad is so big and I'm like, and he's so small at the same time. And I'm like, wow, I was that big and that small. He's taller than I was back then. Oh my gosh, I can't get over that. Anyways, do you have any interesting stories from when you were 4 years old or like one of your first memories? Or even just like things that someone has said to you that really changed who you were and how you acted? I liked living as a tomboy. I liked being a tomboy and it was really fun. But at the same time, I wish I could have indulged myself in the extreme happiness that I feel when I see the color pink or when I see cute things like this. Makes me so happy. My babies! I love you so much!
They're so cute.
So that's it for this video. If you found it fun and interesting, definitely show me by clicking this thing, just so I can visibly see if you enjoyed it. If you want to see more from this channel, definitely make sure to subscribe and click that bell notification to become part of our Nacho family. I also post every day on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and Snapchat, so you can check those out. And that's it. So I will see you next time. I spent a lot of time doing my makeup this morning. I don't know why. I spent so much time doing my makeup this morning. This is the longest I spent doing my makeup in like years. It's crazy, but I think it's so cute. Isn't it cute? I actually was really inspired by Pony's makeup. I copied her pastel watercolor blush. It's like pink, orange, and red at the same time. And then I did some glitter freckles. And I copied her lip shape, how she usually does her lips. But I'm happy with how my makeup turned out today, but I only ended up filming 2 videos, which is okay because I will be streaming and chatting with you and our hamster. If you wanna watch the rewind replaying of that live stream, I can link it right here. You can watch that if you are interested in seeing the hamster. She is so cute. She's so cute. I have emotional attachment issues. I'm like, still not leaving. Okay, bye. Bye. Love you. See you. Love you. See you. Love you. See you. Bye. Today's feature comment is from Mayra. Still waiting for the wedding story. I'm so sorry, Mayra. We're taking like forever to film that video. Oh my gosh. I'm so sorry. It's been so crazy and so busy, but I promise you we'll get back to doing more talk videos, especially together, Michael and I together. But for sure, like, I'm so sorry. Our how we met, our wedding story video, how he asked me out to be his girlfriend, and how he asked me to get married to him. I definitely want to do those 4 within this year, like before like winter time. So hopefully we'll be able to get it done soon. I'm so sorry for taking so long. My deepest apologies. But thank you so much for always watching our videos and always, you know, enjoying them. Your time means so much to us. Thank you for your patience, especially with waiting for me to upload. I'm so sorry. So that's it. I'll see you next time. Peace.